Hi everyone, and welcome back to Open Source Tonight. Folks, I've got a video about the Motif Window Manager for you. I'm going to show you me playing with it a little bit, and let's get right on into it. So we're looking at a Debian system here. I'm going to just log in as root, because why not? Not a good reason, but anyway, that's what we're running as is root. And this is a Linux virtual machine. As you can see, I have logged in. Haven't logged in a while. This is a little system I play with. Last login was April 26th, 3:15 a.m. local time. So let's go ahead and look at our system. So I'm going to actually run X init. And if I do that, we will get the Motif Window Manager set up the way I set it up. You can see here it is right here. And this is a little tool I've been playing with. It's not perfect. But anyway, this is a little thing I've been building. You'll see it kind of fits in with Motif quite well here. And so, you know, this does actually work. There's not enough alerts here to show you, but that's not what we're here for. That auto launches. I'll close that. This is Motif Window Manager. I can create a new terminal here so we can do HTOP, and you can see just how tiny the resource usage is on this system. 224 megs of RAM in use. We're running a GUI here, folks. That's what we're doing. So we can do that. I've got a IRC client here. You can see again, it fits in with the system. So, and then this alert mon here is what you think it is. It's that program I was just showing you earlier. Okay. And we're back. My virtual machine decided to give me problems. Unfortunately, I had to move it to a different drive, and now I've noticed that things are a little bit more delayed. Anyway, hope you can enjoy the experience of the programs happening anyway. So, we had the alert mon up. I've already showed that. I can pull up my terminal. This is xterm. You configure these things through a couple of files, including but not limited to your, here, we'll just do it, nano x resources file. So you can see I actually put the configuration in here. And if we actually get rid of this for xterm and I reopen xterm, well, crap, that didn't actually work. Never mind. So if we look here, I'll show you the config file for our Motif Window Manager. So it's in /x11 MWM M, hold on. System.mwmrc. So this is a file that they want you to copy and paste into your home directory. Now I actually did that. So now I've got a file in here, which I believe you're supposed to call. Yep, here it is. It's .mwmrc in the home directory. So that's the system level one I showed you before. This is the real deal yours one. So if we look around, you can see I can change this. So for example, let's open it up in our text editor of choice and try changing it. So here we go, we are looking at it. And if we scroll down here to new window, let's say that we wanted to make the fonts really small. So instead of 18, we'll make it 8. Next, I'll exit out and I can go right click on my desktop here and click restart. It's gonna say, ask me, and I'm gonna say, okay. And then there we go. Look at that, it's all changed. And just to show you one of the cool things that I learned a while back about Motif Window Manager that you might not have known is this. Let's say that I've got my little program here For some reason, it redraws much slower on the non-SSD. It's interesting how that works. But anyway, because this is on a hard drive, and in the earlier part of the video before my VM had issues, it was on an SSD. Anyway, so now let's say I right-click and I do restart. Watch this. The programs don't disappear. How cool is that, right? They literally stick. Anyway, so let's go ahead and fix our text here because I want a terminal with text that is much bigger. Hence the reason I did that with the command there. So now we will restart, new window, and there we go. See, that should be easier for both you and me to see on video. So this is the enhanced window manager. Now I'm actually going to show you that in action here in just a second. Okay, so if we look here, I have got it executing MWM. All I got to do is change that one line. Let's go ahead and we'll just use my exit button over here for the thing I developed. That's something I'll show later. And now if you'll notice, it's similar, right? But it's not the same. If we minimize a program, you'll see it goes down here in the corner. And we can right click, you'll see the fonts look a little different. I personally kind of preferred the older style, but that's just me. It comes with a tool called XM Toolbox, but you can see here it's going to be upset at me because it's not running as the first process. But it will let us do things like open some programs. So here is in edit. This is a native Motif text editor. It's actually pretty powerful. So we can say, hello, everyone. So this is actually pretty interesting. And you can even load like Python code up in this and it will work just fine. So this program I think is really cool. And so look at that. We can monitor our system utilization. Anyway. This VM keeps stuttering for some reason. That's not the video recording. That's actually a native system. It's weird. So we can open different programs. We don't have GIMP installed. So there's just different things we can install. So for example, it was looking at having links, the links text browser, and it doesn't install this, right? We got to get that ourselves. So let's go do that. We'll go grab that program. And I apologize for the terminal being small. I need to switch back from the enhanced window manager the way that this is set up right now for you to see that. But anyway, I just did an apt install command for installing links. Now, shouldn't have closed that terminal, should I? There we go. That's fine. And now, if I go web browser. Oh. It didn't actually work. Okay, so if I manually run it, I don't know if it's this VM or what. Oh, there it goes. It's up. Okay. Forgot about that. It's been a while since I've used the links. So, but we could go to VincentMagger.com, for example. You know, it doesn't really work correctly because it's trying to render stuff. Like a text post, why I care about captioning, this kind of works. So we can make it a little bigger that way, but I kind of prefer the older window manager. So we can use my program to exit. And we should have done this before we exited, but I'm really bad for forgetting. Let's edit our file here. So we're just going to set that back. Now if I run X init again, you can see we are back, but we're in the real Motif Window Manager now. So I'm going to show you how I've got everything set up here on this Debian system, the way I like it. I have got this X set root command. It sets my background to be light blue. I've got my cursor the default setup, I have got the screen resolution set here because it doesn't auto do that. Then I execute my window manager. Then down here, I've got a couple scripts that I'm running. The second one here is for the dock over here. And then the first one is for that program you've seen that I've been playing around with. So you can do some interesting things with this. Now, we were talking about that window manager, the enhanced window manager, Motif Window Manager. But if we run that XM session thing, you'll see we can do some, well, maybe not. Uh-oh. Oh, it's because my dock's running over top of it, isn't it? Let's disable that. In fact, let's disable the auto start of both of these programs. X in it. And there we go. You can see this program's up in the corner. And if I go to session now, this is something I couldn't do before. I can go log out and I can say I can reboot the system. And let's do that just to see the demo. You'll see it's shutting the virtual machine down right now. I guess we're going to have to leave it there. But anyway, that X init file, that will let us set what we want to do when we type X init. And so we can use that to launch directly into the Motif Window Manager, pre-launch programs we want, whatever. It's basically a script. So folks, I know this is a bit of a longer video, but I hope you enjoyed every second of it. It was trying to really give you a more in-depth look at the Motif Window Manager, which I did have one YouTube viewer request. Here's the user. Thanks for the request. Anyway, everybody, hope you're enjoying open source tonight. And until next time, everybody, thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, everybody. And action.